This project of Muslims that saved Jews in World War II is absolutely nothing whatever to do with making money. What it has everything to do with is to show that there are good people in the world, and we found them in Albania and Kosovo. What's unique about Albania in particular, there are more Jews alive after World War II in Albania than before World War II. There's no evidence of any Jew being turned over to the Nazis. It's a code of honor. It doesn't exist anywhere that I've ever experienced. It's more than just hospitality. They would lay their lives down for a guest. It transcends even Bessa, because what we have found is that people have integrated that into their religion. We've had people say, there is no Bessa without the Quran. There is no Quran without Bessa. To save a life is to go to paradise. I would sooner have my son killed than break my Bessa. There's no way, no way that anyone could break their Bessa. They would be ostracized in their village, and probably even killed. I always ask these people, what was it? Was it Bessa? Was it the Quran? What was it that you risked, you, your family, risked everything to save Jews, in many cases strangers? And they would respond in different ways. I'll give you one story. This happened in northern Albania, in the mountains of Albania. Believe me, it's mountains. We've been there. At any rate, this one individual had a little store, a grocery store, and there was nothing around. And one day, a Nazi truck came through with a series of Albanian prisoners who were on work details, and one Jew they were going to kill. They stopped at the store. Ali invited them in. He spoke German, and he gave them some wine to drink, and he gave them more wine to drink. They got drunk. While they were drinking and carousing, he put a note in a piece of melon and slipped it to the Jewish kid in the truck to run into the woods at a certain spot. He'll find him later. He did. The Nazis went nuts. They threatened to shoot and kill Ali on the spot. They put a gun to his head three times. Where is the Jew? Where is the Jew? He didn't. He said, just completely denied. I know nothing about who this kid was. They threatened to burn the village down. Ultimately, the Nazis left. Ali retrieved this Jewish kid in the woods, brought him back to his home, sheltered him somewhere between 6 months and a year, I'm not quite sure what. And after the war, and nobody in the village knew, and after the war, this kid left, and he went back to Mexico, where he's a dentist. And we, recently in Israel, we had a reunion between the son of Ali and this Jewish guy who's in his 80s now. It was very touching and very warm. That's one story. Mitzvahs, Jewish mitzvahs, good deeds. That's what we're about, good deeds. Everybody does good deeds. I'm fortunate enough to know I think I can take some pictures. So I did it with my pictures, and that's what I've been doing, and I will continue to do.